This base OH minus hydrogen peroxide is a solvent here. This loses this electron pair to this boron, electron deficit,
right?
And then this R minus goes out from this. One by one, all these alkyl groups will eliminate from this. Which takes OH minus from the solution, and then it forms one R will take OH minus forms ROH. 3R one by one it goes out and it forms three molecules.
So it's basically just like 4 OH minus.
Yeah, it's not balanced. Yeah, we'll have excess of this we're using. Okay.
What is H2O2?
H2O2 is a solvent we're using. Solvent actually, we need a medium for a reaction to proceed. Solvent generally, like we have mixed ether over there, in that the reaction is taken. No, HBr condition according to anti-Markovnikov is in presence of peroxide is anti-Markovnikov. Here for reaction it requires H2O. It's a name reaction, right? So reagent everything is picked up, right?
What is the name?
Hydroporation oxidation. No. Okay, what is the product you will get in this reaction? Yes. Hydrocarbons skin addition. Actuation on the same side. The first reaction in the product is what? It is oxymercuration, demercuration, right? So it follows Markovnikov rule, addition of OH and H, right? OH. This is the product. Can you write down the mechanism? First one. Right. Very right. Thank you. For this one, the answer is what? Addition of again OH and H. And you want to write down the answer.
So,
Markovnikov
is only one pole
formed,
but in the other one,
there will be.
We have
3
moles of this.
And
we also use 3 moles of this.
Yeah, yeah.
So, it's not. Is that two long bonds?
Two double bonds, okay.
It wouldn't. Anywhere.
And if you use excess, then both will get ready.
And would I say that OH throws both sides of the carbon?
Because anti-addition, this two must be on the opposite side.
So the lower one on the left would be.
This one, no, it's a methyl.
No, sir, I'm saying if there was a second double bond and the other one methyl, then on the left side, the lower one would be.
This side you're saying?
No,
this
side.
This one.
Yes, sir, that's
this double bond is there?
No, sir, I'm saying if there was a double bond, there on the left side.
Yep, you know.
On top right. On top right. Mm-hmm. On top right.
No, no, no. But being in the sir. I'm saying if double bond is
okay.
And when I do that thing again, would I get.
Exactly the same. Okay. You understood the mechanism, right? Here we have cyclic three-member ring, and then this H2 attack from the back side, right? And then this ring get open up, with this we'll get hydrogen, right? Next, write down oxidation reaction.
This,
we
don't have to worry about ring expansion, contraction, and shifting
carbocation. Yeah. So that we always do when carbocation formation is there. Then only we'll do rearrangement of them. Okay, write down next, oxidation reaction. Write down an alkene can be oxidized to. Not all the esters, but. Okay, write down an alkene can be oxidized to cis1,2 glycol. Cis1,2 glycol on reaction with potassium permanganate on oxidation with on reaction with potassium permanganate in a cold basic solution, an alkene can be oxidized to cis1,2 glycols either by reaction with KMnO4 in cold basic solution and by osmium tetraoxide OSO4. Osmium tetraoxide. Both reagent we can use. Osmium is an element. OSMIUM. Osmium. Osmium tetraoxide formula is OSO4. Okay. We also call it as osmic acid, OSO4. Okay? The reaction you see, CH3CH, double bond CH3CH, KMnO4.
So how would you define cold? Like how?
2-3 degree.
Cold means cold.
So, but like how cold?
Temperature is very, will not increase the temperature. Means less than 5 degrees Celsius. Otherwise, diols can be reduced into alcohol or ketone, you can. It's possible by elimination. Okay. Less than 5 degrees Celsius, you see. Okay, so the product of this reaction is CH3CH. CHCH3, and we'll have the cis addition of this OH. Yes, you have to memorize this here.
So there is no mechanism.
Mechanism, a little bit I'll discuss, but it's not the entire mechanism. Okay.
See, so you get
even this same product you'll get when you have osmium tetraoxide with H2O2. We get cis addition of OH. So diols ka reaction fir it's again you'll get some halohydrin formation. If you simply heat this in basic in acidic medium, then H2O goes out and after that even this goes out. Okay. And we have a carbocation here. Right. So this carbocation and this OH here, right? If you have any nucleophile, that will attack onto this carbocation. That is a half reaction. If you heat this, you must need some nucleophile. So halohydrin formation will take place.
Cis means
same side attack. Syn also you can say. No. See, the OH is attached to from the same side. Okay, osmium will get the same product. You see, KMnO4 converts into MnO4 minus, right? K plus MnO4 minus.
In basic we define
charge. It gets the thing and then it gives it, so there's no net.
This OH minus will have excess of it. This will attack one by one on these two carbon atoms because this bond is polar and eventually it goes out. MnO4 minus.
So how can Mn form
so many bonds?
Mn,
no, but like in total, these are all in all. Because E is 10, plus your P and your S.
You can also form so many bonds. Mn can also form so many.
So what's the thing of Mn? What's the atomic number of Mn?
Atomic number of magnesium. What is the atomic number of magnesium? Ruchi, tell me. 25.
No.
3D series, right? No. After magnesium, what we have? 25. After magnesium, we have iron. So 25. Okay, where is room? D block element, right? So it has expanded octet. Okay, what? So, all these four oxygen atoms inside the corner of the tetrahedron. Okay, so this is the, basically you have to memorize this. Diol forms and both OH on the same side. Okay, still addition of OH. Right? Another write down, next point. See, both, that is not right. When you heat this in acidic medium, and you have suppose some nucleophile here by this. Acidic medium with this water molecules goes out, you have some positive charge here. And then this will attack over here. And this is the formation of halohydrine.
Halohydrine.
We'll see that later. I mean, you don't write it.
So, and that will be a double bond, right?
Where? No, no, no. It's bond. It will be OH and this is
CL. So, then how does water be
the
OH?
H plus comes over here. H2 goes out, positive charge, and then this is. Or nucleophile. So
where does that pass
from? I'm telling you, that's what when you heat this in acidic medium.
Oh,
right. You have to provide that condition of reaction. Okay. Okay. Next slide down. Second point. Next reaction means in under the oxidation part only. Right on. No oxidation. In oxidation only. We can use different reagents. Okay. So first is this. Next slide down. Oxidation with hot alkaline. Oxidation with hot alkaline permanganate. Hot alkaline permanganate. Comma acidic permanganate. Comma acidic permanganate. comma, acidic dichromate. Acidic dichromate. Or potassium per iodate, NaIO4. Or potassium per iodate, NaKIO. Potassium, sodium, both you can take. Okay? Any metal you can take. Potassium per iodate is KIO4. Sodium per iodate is NaIO4. Okay? Potassium per iodate, in presence of catalytic amount of KMnO4. Catalytic amount of KMnO4. That means KMnO4 is behaving as a catalyst, like it is present in a small amount there. Its effect won't be there in the reaction. Okay. Catalytic amount of KMnO4 forms aldehyde, ketones, carboxylic acid, or carbon dioxide. Aldehyde, ketones, carboxylic acid, or carbon dioxide. This reaction you have to memorize, mechanism is not there. 2-3 points we have into this, okay? According to that, we'll write down the product, okay? Aldehyde can form, ketone can form, acid can form, or CO2 also, okay? First point in this, write down. The terminal CH2 group, CO2. Terminal CH2 bond.
So the
if you have
double bond has to be acid.
Right. Terminal CH2 is this, double bond CH2. In bracket, write down. Terminal CH2 of alkene is completely oxidized to CO2 and H2. Terminal CH2 of alkene is completely oxidized to CO2 and H2. Okay, this is the first point. Next point, second point, write down. If an alkyl group is attached to, the double bonded carbon atom, then it is oxidized to aldehyde first, which further oxidizes into carboxylic acid. See, you always remember this. When you do the oxidation of 1 degree alcohol, you will get aldehyde, always. Further, if you oxidize, aldehyde converts into acid, always. 1 degree alcohol to aldehyde to acid. 2 degree alcohol to ketone, which may go under Bayer-Villinger oxidation reaction and forms ester. Okay. But 1 degree alcohol to aldehyde and then acid, always. Right. If you reduce this, then it will drop. Acid to aldehyde, aldehyde to 1 degree acid. Okay? So write down next point. Third one, a double bonded carbon atom having two alkyl group is oxidized to ketone. Okay. You see what is the meaning of all this. Suppose you have an alkene, say CH3, CH2, CH2 double bond, CH2. Okay? This is an alkene. Okay? Based on the 3 points I have given you, we can write the product of this reaction if it goes under oxidation. Suppose the reaction is, very commonly used reagent is KMnO4, OH minus, H plus. CH. Now the product of this, see, it is a terminal double bond, right? So this converts into what? Terminal CO2. So one of the product is CO2, and this carbon dioxide forms from this carbon atom. Okay, one of the product is CO2. Now this will also get oxidized, right? This will oxidize into aldehyde with equal number of carbon atoms, CH3, CH2, CH2, this is aldehyde. First it forms aldehyde, and further, since it is a strong oxidizing agent, so we cannot stop the reaction till here, right? So it further it oxidizes into acid, which is CH3, CH2, COOH. This is a product.
So if you wanted to stop over here, then how do you...
Uske liye we have to use some weaker mild oxidizing agent, like bromine water. But in this reaction, it is not possible. See, if the oxidizing agent is strong, then this will convert into this. So you have to make this weak, so that it won't convert this into this. Aldehyde, whenever the double bond is present, if non-terminal double bond is there, maybe it will reach me, right? Then first you'll get aldehyde, and then you'll get what? Acid. Okay? So this part will go under oxidation, and this part will go under oxidation. Since this is terminal, so this gives you CO2. Oxidation of this gives you aldehyde first with equal number of carbon atom, and then acid with equal number of carbon atom. Now suppose if I take this example, the next reaction, CH3, CH double bond, CH, CH3. Can you tell me the product in this one? Same reaction. Same aldehyde first, and then?
Carboxylic
acid. So can I write down the product is two molecules of CH3, COOH, CHO, and then CH3COH. Okay, I'll write down that. CH3, CHO, which further oxidize into CH3COOH. Okay. Always remember this, that KMnO4 is a very strong oxidizing agent. You won't get aldehyde as a product in this. What is the product in this reaction? That. See, this carbon has two alkyl group, right? So you'll have here ketone, forms ketone. So this is here, and this converts into so if terminal double bond is not there, then we always get acid or ketone. Aldehyde won't form in this reaction. Second reaction, this one. No, see, it is the product, it forms and then it converts into. So, final product is this one. In the mixture, you don't have aldehyde, you only have acid. So, ketone banana. CH3CHO, and further that will oxidize into this acid. Okay. Aldehyde is not forming here, all these converts into this.
So if you have multiple double bonds in the same compound, will it still form the same product?
Yes, all the double bond will break. It's everywhere you have to break and write. Then you will get acid into this. Double bond is to break and write down the carboxylic acid with the equal number of carbon atoms. Okay, if you have to form aldehyde, then we use that NaIO4 or KIO4, right? So write down with potassium periodate or sodium periodate, aldehyde is the major product, or alkene gets oxidized into an aldehyde. KIO4 or NaIO4 is a weaker oxidizing agent than KMnO4, so it cannot oxidize aldehyde further into acid, right? Tell me the product in this reaction. CH3CH, double bond CH2, NaIO4. Product in the same way. No, it is not terminal carbon. It is not CS2, it is C2 and then
it's
carbon dioxide. Yeah, right. We get CO2 and aldehyde. The product for the first one is and for this one it is CS3. So all these 2-3 rules you must remember.